Hey guys, welcome to part 4 of my tutorial series where I address the question whether a Mac Pro 4.1 or Mac Pro 5.1 is still worth it in 2018. And what I'm going to do in this episode is I'm going to show you what graphics cards you can install in your Mac Pro 4.1 or 5.1. And for that, I have picked a Sapphire graphics card. Obviously, when we look on the Apple webpage, you might have noticed that most of these iMacs, they all come with the Radeon RX series, and either it's the, I believe, the 560, the 570, or the 580. And in my case, I just picked the RX 560 because I was on a budget. I bought that old Mac Pro used. So obviously, I also could have taken the RX 580, and that would also have worked, but since I'm not a heavy gamer, I thought I'd just stick with the budget version. I think these cards are around $100. One thing to note, what you should not pick, I believe, is the 550 series, because the 550 series supposedly does not work. And also the 550 series gives you a way less performance for the money. So the 560 and the 580 is, I think, good values and works very well in the Mac Pro. So why don't we just take this out of the box and put this into the iMac and then see the performance that it delivers. Unfortunately, because the stock graphics card that is in here, the NVIDIA GeForce 120, I believe, the Geekbench OpenCL test would not run because the graphics card is simply too old. But on the new one, it will run and it will produce a nice performance. So let's just get rolling and install the graphics card, and I show you what you have to pay attention to. So guys, obviously before we can put in the new graphics card, we have to take out the old one. I took the liberty to loosen this bracket right here. Just carefully take this out, put it to the side. And then next up, we just gently gonna lift out that graphics card. And you see like the attention to detail that Apple has with everything. Even here, they have the numbering. Here they on the disk drives, they have the numbering. I think like these old iMacs, although they're not the newest hardware, they're still, I mean, like from a design perspective, I'm sure this is once going to become a collector's item. And I'm surprised that this is like from 2009 and I'm still with a few upgrades am able to work on this system like as if it's new. So this is the old stock graphics card. When you take this out, don't throw it away. You want to keep this because this has some kind of proprietary BIOS or firmware on it that you will eventually need later on if you maybe want to install Windows 10 for gaming on the system or something like this. This is really, really valuable. Don't throw this away, keep it for later. And now I had to stop the recording for a second and recharge my camera's battery because it was running out. But I was really thinking, guys, I hope you understood the last point that I was trying to make with this old Apple stock graphics card, why this is important. This card can display a boot screen. When you start your Mac and push down the Alt key, it usually shows like some gray screen and sends you into a boot mode where you can select which drive to boot from. But as soon as you take this Apple verified graphics card out with the Apple firmware and you put a non-Apple one in, that's really what I wanted to say, then this gray screen is not gonna appear anymore. Since I have already installed macOS High Sierra on my solid state disk drive down here on the PCI Express SATA 3 card, it's not no problem for me. I just plug in the replacement card and macOS will just boot up normally without displaying the usual Apple boot screen. But other than that, the system runs just fine. But obviously, maybe you can imagine that when you want to install, for example, Windows or do some other stuff, then not having the boot screen is one downside of installing a replacement and upgrading the graphics card. So now right here, what we have is the RX 560. I think this is a really good value to get started. Obviously, you can pick the 582. But for me, the reason why I picked that is that this graphics card consumes about half the energy of the 580. The 580, I believe, is very power hungry. So the 580, you have to supply with power from the, I think the PCIe slot here, the PCI Express slot, excuse me, can supply, I think, 75 watts. And then there are two, I'm gonna zoom in here for you a little bit, two more PCIe Express slots down there that you can connect with. I believe this is called mini PCI Express to PCI Express, and it's a 6-pin cable. And guys, I'm gonna post this below the video because I had a little bit of a confusion going on which cable to choose. And when I looked at these cables, really be careful what kind of cable you buy. This cable is rated for, I hope you can see this, 18 AWG, and that's I think that means it can at 75 watts, which is what the board outputs, as far as I understand it, it can handle the amperage that goes through that wire. Now, for some reason, I read somewhere that people bought these cables for like really, really cheap on eBay, and then maybe they used a different, how do you call this in English, gauged wire that was not 18 AVG or superior rated cable. And then when these cables output a lot of amperage, these cables will actually start to get fried, so to speak. So make sure you get the right cable. I read like some horror stories in the comments. Some people bought this on Amazon, and for some reason the seller, I don't know, was from China or I don't know where. I mean, I don't want to speak badly about China, but if you have, obviously, if you use a low quality cable that can handle the amperage, obviously bad stuff is going to happen. So make sure you get the right one, and I'm going to post this below in the comments so that you can be sure you get the right one. And yeah, with the Radeon RX560, I looked on the Sapphire webpage, and what I found is that this card seems to be relatively energy efficient. So I think this is a reasonable choice to put into the system. Obviously, the power supply, I think, is like a 980 watts power supply. The power supply can handle more, but I don't see why should I use that much energy if I'm not a hardcore gamer. I mean, maybe I change my mind later on after using this card for a while. I can, and that's the nice thing about the Mac Pro. You can always upgrade if you want to. Let's just quickly have a look inside the box, what we can find here. Obviously, some drivers, which we don't need, obviously, since we are on the Mac, and the Mac natively supports this graphics card. So, and maybe what I also can do is, even if you're a gamer, I post the link below the video. There was like a guy who made like insanely in-depth review, gaming-wise, of the performance of this card. And honestly, guys, I was surprised. I mean, unless you have a huge monitor. In my case, I only have a 24-inch monitor, so I'm not going to drive a resolution that's higher than full HD. And the guy tested tons of games on this kind of chip, and what he found is that if you only play games in full HD on medium resolution, this card performs really, really surprisingly well. And he also found that whether you have the 2 gig memory version or the 4 gig memory version, made little to no difference, surprisingly. Check out his review below. It was a really good in-depth review. I mean, it must have taken days to produce these reviews. But what I'm gonna do right now, I'm just gonna put this in, maybe take off these caps here. And yeah. This I already moved to the side, and here you see the 6-pin power connector. Maybe I'm just plugging this in before I install the card. And also notice that this is a 6-pin, and this is like a mini 6-pin. So you really have to pick the right cable, guys. Otherwise, it's a little bit of a mess. And I like the way Sapphire, the cooler that Sapphire has designed here. I think this is a really good cooler that should keep the card really nice and cool, and have a good airflow inside the system. And obviously, this card is going to produce half the heat of, for example, the Sapphire Radeon RX580, because it's just a more, okay, I have to take this out as well, it's just more more humble when it comes to being power hungry. So that's it. Okay, it sits in, it's well seated. So last thing we have to do is connect the mini PCI power adapter. And I think this is like, maybe I can zoom in so that you can see that down there, PCI AUX A and PCI AUX B, and I'm gonna connect it to A. And yeah guys, there you go. I plugged it in and maybe zoom out a little bit. That's basically all there is to it. If you would have the bigger graphics card, obviously you would have to have two of these cables and I believe like an adapter. So you have two mini PCI to six pin mini PCI to six pin PCI. So you're taking both. Sorry guys, I was briefly interrupted. Someone did ring at the door. Anyway, if you have the bigger graphics card, the 580, you would have to use both mini PCI auxiliary connectors from the board. And like I told you before, like that would be 150 watts that can be drawn from there. And then another 75 from the PCIe Express slot. So you can see a bigger graphics card also means it's more power hungry and it will create more heat inside your system. Obviously you will have to have, you will have with the 580, you will have the mental gaming performance. That much is for sure. And so let's pack this up. Everything is installed and I'm just gonna close this system back up again, and then we're gonna do a performance test and run the benchmark on the system. So let's do this right now.
So guys, basically what I did, I tested the Radeon RX 560 in this max system. Obviously, like I told you before, the old graphics card, the stock Apple graphics card, for example, I tested with Geekbench, and if I run Geekbench on the system with the old graphics card, I even couldn't run this OpenCL test. Here I did a total of three tests and I saved these tests in my Geekbench browser. So those are the kind of scores that you're kind of getting, a 66 or 67 kind of range. And basically the only difference that I did between those scores is A, upgrade the CPU, and B, change the memory clock speed. So here I put in a new CPU, and then in the third test, I updated the clock speed. That was like a little bit tricky because when I put in the memory modules, it would not run at the full clock speed. So I had to do the PRAM reset with this key combination, but more to that in the memory tutorial. And to give you a little bit better of an idea, these results are pretty good. On average, I found, I looked at the comparable scores of the Radeon RX 580, which is a significantly more expensive model, and the 580 had on average twice the performance. So if you think about that, you can pick up a Radeon RX 560 here for about $100-$120, and the 580, I think it's like $300 or something. The 560 has a good value. So I'm very happy with it. I played a bunch of games just to test the performance. And yeah, I mean, what kind of games can you expect to run with a RX 560 and an old 2009 Mac Pro? In my case, I can run Deus Ex Mankind Divided. I can run Hitman Absolution. I can run XCOM 2. Obviously, you will not put them in the highest possible graphics settings. You will not run it on Ultra. But then again, the RX 560 is a budget graphics card. So overall, I noticed really, really nice performance gains. The desktop is really, really snappy. If I would go into iMovie, what I noticed when I use my projects is that everything that I do, like editing on the timeline, moving stuff around, feels really, really snappy. So I couldn't be happier. For video editing, it really gave my system like a really, really powerful refresh. And that means if you're on a budget, the 560 is a great choice. Obviously, if you have more money to spend, go ahead, take the 580. But like I said, it also draws about twice the power, costs almost more than twice the price, and also gives you twice the performance. So overall, I think the difference is not too bad, and I would say we are jumping back away from the desktop to the conclusion in the video, which would be part four of my tutorial series. So let's jump back to the video.
So guys, this concludes the tutorial four in my tutorial series, where I show you how to get the most out of your old Mac Pro 4.1 or 4.5 5.1, and yeah, I'm sure I've shown you that installing the graphics card is really, really easy. No big deal. You can just swap it out if you pick the right one. I told you don't pick the RX 550, that supposedly doesn't work, and the 550 doesn't have as much value. I told you about that you should really keep your stock graphics card if you maybe you need it later on. If you want to reinstall the system or install Windows 10 or something like this, then it's really handy to keep the old graphics card around. And just a quick recap of what I've shown you so far in this tutorial series. First, in the first tutorial, I showed you how to fix the Bluetooth issue that sometimes occurs with the Mac Pro 4.1 and 5.1 by just attaching Wi-Fi antenna. Then in part two, I showed you how to install High Sierra on the 4.1, although Apple doesn't permit it, but or doesn't allow it, but you can really easily circumvent it by manually flashing the firmware. And I also showed you how to create a bootable USB stick or hard drive. And then in part three, I showed you how to max out the performance of your Mac Pro by installing a solid state disk drive. And not only did I show you how to use the solid state disk drive, but I also showed you how to use this PCI Express SATA 3 adapter so that you can get 100% of the speed out of the Mac Pro, because usually it only has SATA 2. In this tutorial 4, I showed you the graphics card, and next up we're going to test the memory, because I have a memory upgrade lying on my table here. And in part 6, I'm going to show you the CPU, which is also coming soon. So next up, the memory upgrade. And yeah guys, I'm not sure, have I even mentioned this before in this tutorial series? I have created on my channel page, maybe just head over to my channel page and hit that subscribe button. And I have created like an online course where I researched over the last 2 years how people have became successful online. And one guy apparently earns $200,000 every month online with his online business, which is like ridiculous. I mean, I went to business school at one of the top universities in Germany. And I think even if you went to business school or if you have an MBA, you're not gonna earn that much money. So why don't you head over to my channel page, and maybe I can show this to you here in the top right corner. There you can find a link that you can follow to my online training platform. And on my online training platform, I have collected the case studies over the last 2 years that show how people became successful online, like how a factory worker became super successful, being able to buy a Lambo and travel the world, how a car salesman became super successful, and so on and so forth. So I've collected case studies from around the world that show you how people became successful so that you can replicate that. And I invite you to check out these case studies. So with that, let's jump to tutorial number 5, where I show you how to upgrade your Mac Pro's memory with server grade memory that I got really, really cheaply, and that you also probably can get really, really cheaply. So I see you in the next tutorial. Take care.
So up next, we're going to install this memory that I got like for $80 off of eBay, which was used, but seems to be really, really high quality, and so far it's performing really well. And I'm going to show you how to install that in just a second, once you have decided to watch the next video. And yeah guys, more and more people surprisingly have already subscribed to my channel. It must be because of the useful content. Obviously you are invited to do the same thing, and maybe also check out one of my online courses. So I see you in the next video. Take care.